Hi, everybody. Congratulations, class of 2020, on this big moment of accomplishment. Both Deborah and I hope you are well and safe and savoring this day because you all earned it. Now, it is a little bit different than what you may have had in mind when you began senior year with so much excitement, so much promise. As we all know, this world has changed a lot.
In fact, we both have to admit that it wasn't easy trying to figure out what to say at this moment in time as we commemorate this special time. A few weeks ago, we would have been talking about the pandemic, urging you to hold on and to begin moving on through this difficult time. Well, now the world is shifting even more, exposing deep and painful fissures around us, around the issues of race and injustice. You were always going to be stepping out into a complex world, no doubt about that, but now you're also stepping into a world that is hurting. And if you are frustrated or maybe even a little anxious, that's understandable. Life is complicated, and that's the final big lesson that you're going to have to take away with you as you graduate.
But we want you to pause and think differently about your circumstances. Yes, this is an unusual graduation. Yes, things are a bit unsettling. And yes, it's going to take big changes and big ideas. And that's where you all come in. You are a graduating class that will go down in history. Some might even say you're a chosen group of graduates. Now, I know you're rolling your eyes, and I've got teenagers. I've seen some eye rolls. But think for just a few seconds. All 2,500 of you have an opportunity to step up. Not just to get your diplomas, but to show the world what it means to pivot in the face of difficulty, to create meaning and success in any situation, whether it's a pandemic or a change in our racial evaluations, how we see people, how people see us, when the things you are expecting to do don't go the way you expected it to.
Now, most of you have had supportive family or friends in your corner to get you this far. There have been days, I am sure, where you felt like you just didn't have it in you. You didn't want to give 100%. Someone probably nudged you along, and if they were like my parents, they probably threatened you to get you to get your act together or else. Well, someone cared enough about you to get you through, to make sure that you did that last project, passed that test, won that football game. Somebody helped you get here and to succeed, got you over the hump, made sure you didn't fail. Well, now it's on you. It's up to you to get past these obstacles, these moments of concern, and of course, some disappointment.
Okay, so we know that this year ended in unexpected ways, and we still don't even know how it's going to end. You didn't get to go to prom. You didn't have those final basketball games. You didn't get to pull those final senior pranks on the teachers you weren't so crazy about. And you're not getting that strut across the stage right now to grab that diploma and hear your families carry on way too loud. No one can blame you for feeling bummed, class of 2020. No pomp today. That is your circumstance. But now it is up to you to decide what to do with this moment, how to take these struggles and make this a better world.
When I was growing up in small town Georgia, post-segregated Georgia, I too had my world rattled in a really big way. All those civil rights marches and struggles had led to a monumental Supreme Court decision, Brown versus the Board of Education, which later threw open the schools to integration. Now, after attending an all-black school for most of my life, for the first 4 years of my life anyway, I was now stepping into a new and kind of bewildering world. It was kind of bewildering to some of my classmates and their parents. Some of them might have been even disappointed with this new and unsettling time. How are we going to cope with this unknown? Some of them might have asked. Some no doubt wanted to know what this is going to mean for the future. It was a new time. It required a different way of thinking. Well, now, this was no pandemic at that time. There was some social distance, I have to say, and there was great fear in stepping out into the new world. But like so many of my classmates, I decided that this was a moment to change the equation, to find ways to excel, to be stronger than those who were fearful, to reach deep down and to find my greatness.
And in fact, given what is going on right now with all the protests, with a resurgence of civil rights, and a lot of young people like you leading the way. Class of 2020, this is your moment, your chance to take what history is handing to you and to find your greatness. Some of you are celebrating extraordinary success, scholarships, acceptance to elite colleges, even the honor of introducing a former president of the United States during an online talk. Some of you are the first in your families to finish high school and to take steps toward a more promising life. Some of you may even help find a cure for this virus or emerge as leaders in our country, helping us find a new way. And we desperately need new creative leaders. We are so very proud of you, along with Superintendent Talisa Dixon.
You are our future, our hope of getting past these difficult times and on to something better. Okay, yes, we may be wearing masks for a little while and maybe doing elbow bumps for a little bit longer until we get there, but we will get to a better place because of you. So as former First Lady Michelle Obama suggested, do a little dance today. Celebrate yourselves. Don't do that dance, please. But celebrate yourselves because you have earned this moment and nothing, nothing can take that away from you.
So as you step out into this big, complicated, unpredictable world of ours, well, I like to do predictions, but that's a whole other story. I urge you to step boldly. Do it like you mean it. Make your decisions count. Someone once said, every decision that we make leads us down a different road. We'll never come to exactly the same crossroads. Every decision that we make has significance. The tiniest choice that we make reverberates throughout the entire universe.
So today, class of 2020, accept your moment in history. They are going to be talking about you for a long time. You are the class that stepped back out into the light after some dark days. You are the class that is going to change the way we go forward. As the great Maya Angelou says, up from the past that's rooted in pain, I rise.
So class of 2020, you rise. Give yourselves a personal hug. Give your classmates a virtual fist bump. Give your folks your deepest gratitude and celebrate yourselves wherever you are right now. This is your moment of achievement and nothing can take that away.
Congratulations, class of 2020.
Hello, family and friends. In just a few moments, the 2020 commencement ceremony for Beechcroft High School will begin. We are here to celebrate each student's personal successes and accomplishments. Nothing has been typical about this year's graduating class. You have stayed focused through a pandemic crisis. Amid protest for social injustice, your generation has provided leadership. Young people, you are more knowledgeable and accepting of people regardless of their socioeconomic status than any other generation before you. Class of 2020, you are truly the hope and change that we all need in our society today. Please join us as we celebrate your 2020 graduating seniors. Each year, our graduating seniors have the opportunity to select any staff member who has had a great impact on their educational success to give them their diplomas. Beechcroft High School staff members, mentors, coaches, and guests were honored with that recognition, and their names have been included in your programs along with the graduate who acknowledged them. Thank you for your contributions to our students. I will now introduce our 2020 Beechcroft graduation speakers in the order that they appear in your program. Michelle Arheen is our senior class vice president. Throughout her years at Beechcroft, she has participated in volleyball, band, rocks, track, freshman fusion, and was the band secretary and a basketball manager. She will be attending The Ohio State University in the fall. Marie Beaugris is our first class speaker. She has attended Beechcroft for the past 3 years and was member of our Beechcroft marching band. Marie plans to continue her education at Columbus State. Adeola Moshood is our next class speaker. During her time at Beechcroft, she has participated in the STEM club, theater arts, and marching band. She plans to continue her education at The Ohio State University. Tierra Hale is our final class speaker. During her time at Beechcroft, Tierra has participated in volleyball, basketball, STEM club, National Honor Society, and peer mediation. She plans to continue her education at Kentucky State University. Maxime Ngupa is our senior class president. During his time at Beechcroft, Maxime has participated in tennis, soccer, bowling, and the National Honor Society. Maxime plans to continue his education at The Ohio State University.
On behalf of Beechcroft High School senior class and staff, we welcome you to the 2020 Beechcroft High School graduation ceremony. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Michelle Ahan, senior class vice president here at Beechcroft High School. First, I'd like to say that I'm more than honored for this opportunity to welcome my fellow high school graduates to Beechcroft's commencement ceremony. I'm truly proud of us as a class. Unfortunately, though we were met with uncontrollable circumstances, we did not let that stop us. We were determined and persistent in finishing out the school year stronger than any other senior class. I know our final year did not go as planned, canceled prom and senior breakfast, as well as untraditional graduations. But we did not let this pandemic define us. But as a class and as a community, we have been able to rise above it, proving whatever we put our minds to, we will acquire it. Class of 2020, we are the class of the future. Yes, this is the end of our high school chapter. Bittersweet, I know. However, it's also a beginning towards a great journey for the rest of our lives. Please join us now as we honor the country by reciting the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Seniors, it is my honor to address the class of 2020 and congratulate each of you on your graduation. Though you're not together with your classmates in the same place to mark this important milestone, I am no less proud of each of you. It does not diminish your achievements individually or collectively. As I pre-record this message today, which is Monday, June 15th, to address the class of 2020, all of us are reeling from a roller coaster of raw emotions. Each of you and your families, our city, our country, and the entire world is still coping with the health and economic impacts of the COVID-19 world pandemic. And our hearts and minds continue to be filled with sadness, anger, frustration, and disgust at yet another brutal act against a member of the African American community. Columbus City Schools has reaffirmed its commitment to the fight to overcome systemic racism and working for change in our schools and in our community. As superintendent, together with the Board of Education, I am committed to making meaningful, forward-thinking changes that address racism, sexism, and gender and religious-based biases inside and outside of our classrooms. Today, I ask each of you to join me by making your own commitment to be an agent of change. The commitment to change is how you decide to define it. And you should know that your definition of change will, well, change. It is what former First Lady Michelle Obama calls becoming. I believe we need immediate change and we need long-term, lasting change. In fact, we must demand both. We cannot stay the same as individuals if we are to transform as a community and as a society. I close with a quote from President Barack Obama, as told by Michelle Obama in her book, Becoming. She quotes the president as telling those who join him to address social change from the streets of Chicago to the halls of the White House. Do we settle for the world as it is, or do we work for the world as it should be? My call, my challenge to the class of 2020 is a commitment to the latter. Please celebrate change. Please be the change.
Good morning, family, friends, teachers, and fellow graduates. My name is Busma Mali Brege, and I'm proud to be from a West African country called the Ivory Coast. 4 years ago, I moved to the United States with my family. And just 2 months after that, my parents enrolled me in school. My parents, like many, wanted their child to be successful, and education is the key to success. I was excited to go to a new school, to meet new people, make new friends, and learn new things. But I forgot about one little obstacle. I knew very little English. I speak fluent French and some African languages. But the only English words I knew were good morning and how are you? Other than that, I knew nothing else. This was going to be an issue, a bit of a battle on my road to success. I was ready to overcome it. On my first day of school, I entered the school office with my dad. But then minutes later, I'm left alone with students to show me around the school. I was worried at this point, since my English wasn't good. Thankfully, he was a French speaker. And so in my head, I was like, well, I told in America, they all speak English, but I speak French too. We stopped in front of the classroom, and he said in French, voici ta classe, rentre, meaning here's your classroom, get in. I was happy, thinking this whole new country potential language barrier wasn't going to be an issue. Confirming my hopes, I asked him, so everyone speaks French, right? He said no. I was shocked and scared at the same time because I knew how hard things would be. I told him I wouldn't go into the classroom because I didn't know how it feels like being with people who speak English fluently. I remember him pushing me into the classroom and introducing me to the teacher, who asked me, how are you? I answered, fine. And you? I thought it was over, and I could get through this incredible challenge moment with all I knew how to say in English. But she kept talking, and I understood nothing. I felt lost, like I didn't belong there. So I had no more option than saying yes to everything she was saying, even though I understood nothing. With the goal of her not asking more questions. But the teacher was mad, and she knew I understood nothing. She took her phone and translated what she wanted to say into French. And then, of course, we understood each other. I felt happy because I found a new way of communication and thought things would get easy, but I was wrong. Things never got easy. They actually became even more challenging. As an ESL student, everything is hard. Imagine getting a homework assignment in a foreign language. First, you have to translate it into your native language just to even understand what the assignment is. Then, you think of the answer in your native language and translate to that new language you are required to learn. Everything feels like double and maybe triple the work. Working in it toward an education with the goal of success is already hard, but it's an extra struggle we go through as ESS students. Today, I want to take this time to thank all our teachers, but especially our ESL teachers. We know the struggle you go through with us and for us. To all 2020 seniors, we all know what Dr. King said. Well, I have a dream too, so do all of you. Things might be a battle for you, and you will have to work hard, but I want to tell you to have a goal and to work to make that goal. Then you can set a new goal and you will see that your life will start to be made by more of moral success. Life is made of a lot of little battles, and sometimes by losing the battle, you find a way to win the war. Don't be afraid to think outside the box, like using a Google Translator to get through a conversation. And to everyone, but especially my fellow ESL students, always remember where you came from and the dream you had by coming here to have a better education and a successful life. This is only the beginning of a long way to success. Thank you.
Good afternoon. Welcome to all the principals, staff, and guests. As the class of 2020, we want to thank the principals, teachers, counselors, coaches who helped us through our 4 years. We also want to say how much we appreciate the I Know I Can advisors and the teachers for their relentless efforts towards preparing us for college and for our futures. Thank you. We want to thank our families who saw us through high school in these past few tough months as we completed our classwork from home. Above all, we want to thank God for making this day possible. Now, I want to welcome the class of 2020 and congratulate everyone on making it. What a year we had. This will go down in history. Of course, this is not how we expected our senior year to end. Many of us had high hopes for this particular year. But due to the pandemic, we missed out on certain events dedicated to the seniors. Still, here we are. And no moment in high school could be as precious as our graduation ceremony, because it is the greatest achievement for us as seniors. At the beginning of senior year, I had asked several seniors about what they wanted to achieve this year. Someone said, "I want to gain all my credits in order to graduate," while some others simply said they wanted to graduate. Someone else said, "It's a year to find out who I am." Another said, "I want to be positive. It's a year of positivity." And some even said, "I just want to have fun," which I agree with. So, did you meet your goals? Yes, you did. Yes, we did. And we are here to celebrate the result. Graduation would not be the same, but we are fortunate to be here, to be healthy, and to have our futures ahead of us. We can all say that this year we have been more responsible for ourselves and have gained insights about how our world after today may look. We have shown how amazing we are by our continuous involvement with our education despite the crisis. This portrays our readiness and responsiveness. To the graduating class of 2020, it's time to unveil our full potential. Let us go out there and prove to the world that we are needed. As we graduate and move into the world, we will help shape that world and bring improvements to all of our tomorrows. We will stay positive regardless of what is thrown at us. We are stronger than our challenges. As we proceed into the unknown, be it college, the military, or a job, some words of encouragement for us all are to stay positive, make use of every opportunity we are open to, and never give up. When we fall, let us not forget to stand back up, because that is what makes us strong. Keep aiming for the best. As we go on our separate path in life, I hope that from this day on and beyond, we have a meaningful experience with the real world. Thank you.
2020, the perfect vision, right? Our last year being high school students, last first day of high school, last homecoming, last high school everything, a perfect year for being a senior. We were all looking forward to these moments, including senior breakfast, prom, senior skip day, or even senior night for our extracurricular activities. Our perfect vision became a blur the day we found out that we weren't going to be walking through those halls again, the halls we've been walking since freshman orientation. They told us then our 4 years would fly by, but we didn't believe it. And now, just like that, we are graduating, but not in the way we envisioned. Not being in Beechcroft has been hard, but it's allowed me to reflect the good times and the bad. With reflection, the blurred vision starts to become a little more clear. You start to remember the little things, the things you probably thought were not that important. Like, remember when you were worried about that one homework assignment you left at home? Or that day you forgot your group was presenting first? How about the time you went home and had a pile of homework staring at you? Or that time you woke up on the wrong side of the bed, but that teacher greeted you with a warm smile? And don't forget, hey, 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 Mrs. Moshe. Or even that one practice you remember having fun, or the other one where fun was nowhere to be found. Getting that big win with your teammates, or taking that tough loss. Those little things are what makes us see everything clear, but it reminds us we took some things for granted. When school closed, we started questioning how our senior year will end. How will we graduate? What about our grades and homework? Are we done? We started to panic all over again. Our counselors, teachers, administrators, everyone tried their very best to keep us motivated. Our families told us we are not alone, that they understand how we feel. But truthfully, only we know how each other feel. Reflecting on the memories of the little things, the things we took for granted, they start to seem like the clarity we missed when our year got blurry. Our perfect vision became unclear. However, through all this, in this moment, it couldn't be any clearer than right now. I know one time during your life, someone has told you everything happens for a reason. At first we wondered, why now? Why our senior year? But that has not only caused us to reflect, but has made us grow and become more independent and really think about what our future holds. Yeah, we don't hear Mrs. Moshe quotes of the day, Dr. Johnson yelling dress code mode, or we must do the amazing to be amazing, but that's what we did, the amazing. But we won't forget those little things either. Through the hard times going on in the world now, we've still finished our senior year. We're graduating. Many of us are going off to college, joining the military, or even becoming entrepreneurs, athletes, dancers, musicians, actors, engineers, doctors, and trainers. So many different career pathways. Committing to our next journey of life. It couldn't get any better than this. Now, does that vision still seem blurry? If you think yes, why? You should not feel down or bad anymore because you made it. You didn't let the world stop you. And if you do, let those feelings drive you to achieve your goals and success. Even though we're all going our separate ways, some close and some far, this moment will forever keep us close. Only we can tell this story because we're the only ones who truly know how it felt. And even though our story seemed uncertain, it also gave us reason to show our strength. I know for a fact each one of us are going to do something amazing once we get out into the real world. I mean, we are 2020. We are the best class. It's only right we keep going, keep making history, and keep that 2020 vision as clear as possible. Thank you.
Columbus City Schools, to the class of 2020, congratulations. It's your boy, E.T. Let me just share with you three things that I think are important. All right, so I know you were disappointed. I mean, I get it. I will never forget my junior year in high school. You know, I finally did driver's ed, you know, applied for my driver's license. You know, I took the test, you know, did the driver's test, and voila, got my license, right? And my mom blessed me with her old car. I never forget, Escort. I'll never forget, it was an 84 Escort, right? Super pumped up. Guys, in the first 2 weeks of me having the vehicle, guess what? I got into a car accident, right? And I remember it like yesterday. It was a hit and run. I remember I hit this old lady. I wasn't paying attention. Didn't stop at the red light. Crashed into her. And look, I'm going to be real with y'all. I was so nervous. I was so afraid. I actually drove the car that I broke that axle. You could hardly drive it. I drove that sucker up the street, got out, and ran. Yup, I ran from the scene of the crime. And I'll never forget police calling my mom. I'll never forget the police coming by the house. and I lost my car. I wasn't able to do certain things. And I just remember an old wise person saying this to me. At some point, regardless of how difficult it is, how challenging it is, how hurt you are that you got your license, your first car, and you totaled it, you got to get over it. All right, come on. I'm talking to somebody today. As devastating as COVID-19 was and is, and how it rocked our worlds and changed our plans, at some point, you have to put it behind you in the rearview mirror, and you got to move forward. Are you hearing what I'm saying? And guess what? This is probably not going to surprise you, but I've had 3 or 4 cars since then. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? I've had 3 or 4 cars. So where your focus goes, your energy flows. So if you're going to continue to think about, I didn't get to graduate, you know, I didn't get a prom, I didn't go on my senior trip. Like, if you focus on everything that didn't happen, you know what? You're going to go on a spiral downward. I will never forget growing up a Detroit Lion fan and Barry Sanders, who's probably one of the greatest running backs to ever do it. I remember he wouldn't celebrate. And I would always ask, like, why is he not celebrating like some of the other football players? You know what he said? He said, my daddy told me, you will continue to score. You're going to keep getting touchdowns. You're going to keep getting a lot of yards. Like, don't act brand new. Don't act like you're not going to do it again. Guys, you're going to get opportunities to graduate college. You're going to get opportunities to graduate law school, graduate from medical school. All right, whatever. You're going to get opportunities. All right, so let's put this behind us. Remember, where your focus goes, your energy flows. So this leads me to number 2. Look, if you got bad energy, all right, you're probably going to give 70%, 80%. When you have good energy, you're going to give 120%. And watch me. You actually attract more by being 120 than you attract at 70. All right, let me just be real. You know what I'm talking about. Some of you don't like to wash the dishes. Some of you don't like to do the trash. Some of you don't like to cut the grass. Like, you just don't like chores. Some of you don't like doing homework. And watch this. When you do things and you don't like to do those things, you don't put the same energy in. And as a result, you don't get the same outcomes, guys. If you want to blow up, if you want to make a lot of money, if you want to live in a gated community, if you want to drive whatever car you want to drive, if you want to be your own boss, if you want to be an entrepreneur, if you want to change the world, like, if you got dreams, goals, and plans, you cannot waste your energy. Listen to me. You only get 24 hours in a day. You only get so many opportunities. You can't waste those opportunities because you own something negative. You can't waste those opportunities because you don't particularly care for this, or you don't particularly like. Here's what my parents used to tell me back in the day. Listen to me, you don't have to like washing the dishes, but you're gonna wash them anyway. You don't have to like cutting the grass, but you're gonna cut it anyway. You don't have to like taking out the trash, but you're gonna have to take it out anyway. You don't have to like going to school, but you're gonna go anyway. If I were you, since I have to do it anyway, I would enjoy it. And so you got to find a way when others are down and out. You got to find a way when others don't like it. You got to learn to enjoy the sun, but you also got to enjoy the rain. You got to know that while you love playing in the sun, if it was only sun, if only the sunshine, then the trees wouldn't grow and the flowers wouldn't grow. And we wouldn't get vegetables. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Everybody loves the sun, but can you stand the rain? And what I need you to understand is that there are blessings when the sun shines. There are blessings. Oh, come on. When the rain comes down, there are blessings when it snows. Do you know in certain places in the United States of America that when it actually gets cold in wintertime, do you understand that it kills certain germs? It kills certain bugs? There are blessings in what you would think is a cursing. I'll never forget, my wife got diagnosed with multiple sclerosis about 5 years ago. Oh, when I tell you one of the best things that could have happened to our marriage, best thing could have happened to our career, best thing could have happened to our family. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? Why? Because she left her job. Because we started exercising more. Because we changed our diet. Right? Because we started traveling the world together. And there were opportunities that came to us that had she not gotten sick, she would still be at her job for the next 20 years. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Your attitude determines your altitude. Are you hearing me? And so oftentimes you think it's the circumstance. or you think it's the situations that's a blessing. No, it's your perspective, how you see it. Henry Ford says, if you think you can, you're right. If you think you can't, you're right. I'm going to say it again. If you think you can, you can. If you think you can't, you can't. And so I need you to change your attitude. I need you, when it's bad, I need you to see it's good. When it's good, I need you to see it's good. And when it's great, I need you to see it's great. I'll say it again. When it's great, I need you to see that it's great. When it's good, I think you need to see it as great. And when it's bad, you need to see it as great. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Your attitude actually determines the outcome. The outcome don't determine the outcome. The circumstance and the situation doesn't determine the outcome. You determine the outcome. Now listen to me. I got two more things for you. The next one I want to say to you is, listen to me. I dare you to dream. I want you to dream the dream, but then I want you to work it. Listen to me. The dream works, but you got to work it. The only place where success comes before work is in the dictionary. Are you hearing me? The only place where success comes before work is in the dictionary. You can have it, but you got to work for it. And then my final one, when you become an adult, there are going to be days that you just don't feel like trying. But here's what I want you to do for me. I want you to always remember, I can, I will, and I must. In your darkest days, I need you to repeat that. I can, I will, I must. So as I leave, I know you remember the story. I know you remember the story. The little train that could. Yep. I know you remember that train when it looked at the train track and it looked at how that train track was. It said, I don't know if I could do that. I don't know it. Something said, just get on the track. Like, just give it a try. And so it got on that little train, got on the track. Chugga, 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 choo. Chugga, 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 choo. Choo. And it got on that track and it started going a little bit. And start going a little bit and start. Listen to me very closely. In life, sometimes you won't feel like it, but if you put your shoes on anyhow. Sometimes in life, you're not going to feel like it, but if you put your pants on anyhow. Sometimes in life, you're not going to feel it, but if you put your hoodie on anyhow. Sometimes in life, you may not feel it, but if you put your baseball cap on anyhow. Sometimes in life, you're not going to want to do it, but if you try anyhow, you're going to find that you can muster up the strength, that you can muster up the attitude, that you can muster up everything you need to be everything you need to be. And that doggone train got on that track. And after a while, it said, I think I can. I think I can. And it got up that hill a little bit more and said, I think I can. I think I can. And as it got to the hardest part, it says, I know I can. Chugga, chugga, choo. Chugga, chugga, choo. I think I can. I think I can. I think I can. I think I can. And you do I think I can enough till you wake up and say, I know I can. I got my GED. I think I could go to college. I got my four-year degree. I think I could get my master's. I got my master's degree. I know I could get my PhD. Come on, ladies, say it with attitude. I know I can. I know I can. I can, I will, I'm a, come on, fellas, say it. I can, give me that bass. I can, I will, I must. Remember, you can because you have the ability to. I will because you have what it takes. I must because somebody's counting on you. It's your boy, E.T. Congratulations to the class of 2020. Make your next move, your best move. And make the rest of your life the best of your life. It's your boy E.T. 2020, the world is yours. I'm gonna take it.
I would like to thank all of our speakers for those insightful words of wisdom. And now, for the moment that you have all been waiting for, I present to you the Beechcroft High School class of 2020. Dr. Dixon and board, I hereby certify to you that the 2020 graduating class of Beechcroft High School has met the prescribed graduation requirements of the United States Department of Education and the Columbus Board of Education, and each is prepared to receive the appropriate diploma.
Mohammed Abdi. Muna Abdi. Shamarke M. Abdi. Jesbori Elizabeth Adederon. Adedeo Adiafa Emmanuel. Abdulkadir S. Ahmed. Champagne Monique Alexander. Hamza Al Gabit. Zainab A. Al Gabit. Anissa Ali. Halima J. Ali. Isa Abdi Rashid Ali. Musa A. Ali. Naima Muhammad Ali. Nazare Eliza Alvarado. Daniel Ansa. Michael B. Anubi. Abdi Fatah B. Areb. Abdimajid Areb. Michelle Abena Ahin. Sarai Renee Armistead. Swada A. Ator. Saidu Muhammad Awed. Seamus Muhammad Awed. Mark Allen Bailey. Andrew Baldwin. Mariama Philippa Berry. Hamadou Berry. Armani Yave Bays. Bosama Marie Baguri. DeShannon C. Butler, Jr. Ibrahim Kamara. Corinne Carr. Usamane Kalei Cassette. Ayana Janae Cook. Jamie A. Cornejo Aranda. Ahmed Khalifa Dabo. Marvin C. Daniels. Island S. V. Davis. Alania The Voice. Abdi Jabbar Abdir Dirie. Ilhan Abdikadir Dirie. Eric A. Escobar. Ethan A. Evans. Angelini Fataki. Tasia Sheree Fort. Ariana Gaines. Lenaric Gatewood. Sahara Hassan Jelle. Marlene Gomez. Danielle N. Green. Kamari Gulamez Campbell. Carlos Guzman. Ahmed Hade. Tierra N. Hale. Eka Hamisi. Demarjian D. Harris. Christian Hasty. Shania Tanae Henderson. Dialaje Lovey Hill. Kyron Kalik Hoover. Kevin Huen. Faiza Abdi Ibrahim. Ashley Lene Johnson. Devon D. Jones. Micah I. Jordan. Frank Joseph. Isla M. Juarez. Moses P. Cabea. Aloysius Kamara. Mohammed Silla Kargbo. Umesh Katel. Samuel G. Kyre. Jaquan N. Lane. Haley A. Locker. Joshua Mang. Zende Niall Mathurin. Sophia Antonia Maddox. Trayvon D. McConnell. Mijayla S. McNeil. Devon Miller. Fatih A. Mohammed. Zemzem Abdullahi Mohammed. Amal O. Mohammed. Micaiah Shalay Montgomery. Louis D. Moore. Dynasty D. Morgan. Adiola E. Moshood. Samia Mumin. Aline Mutagara. Rachel Neal. Micah Newell. Maxime Nagupa. Mauricio Nanato. Amanda Nicole Nanato Torres. Jose F. Nunez Reyes. Zawadi Narabishichi. Gabrielle O'Brien. Eben William Tay Okansi, Jr. Mariana Olvera Suarez. Kimberly V. Ortiz Guzman. Pedro A. Ortiz Guzman. Leah Ose Ajay. Evelyn Hope Pence. Dejanay Purnell. Matthew Solomon Perpignan. Carissa A. Pleasant. Salato Mohammed Raj. Govinda Rasali. Preston Dakota Radcliffe. Anna N. Renderos. Destiny Janae Robertson. Aisha Sadika. William A. Sario. Liesha L. Sebastian. Henry N. Cisse. Fieza A. Sheikh. Alahaji O. Sidibe. Victoria Ashley Simmons. Rhonda H. Solomon. Cameron Turner. Amere Umentone. Emmanuel Danielle Uzu. Jamia E. Beck. Kifa Warsame. Natasha Watson. Eric Cameron Williams. Nicole Ayana Williams. Christian T. Wilson. Rashe Amare Wilson. Trinity Nadia Wingfield. Devon Maurice Wooden. Nastejo Youssef.
Class of 2020, it is the privilege of the Columbus Board of Education to accept the certification of your diplomas. Let us be the first to officially congratulate you.
Congratulations, Class of 2020. We are so proud of you.
Columbus graduates, congratulations and best wishes for success.
COVID y el racismo no pueden deteneros. COVID y el racismo no pueden para nos arrestar. COVID and racism can't stop us. Congratulations, Class of 2020.
Board member Dr. Tina Pierce here. Congratulations, Class of 2020. I can't wait to see all the great things you will achieve in the future.
Congratulations, Class of 2020. We love you and all the best.
Carpe diem. Seize the day. Felicidades. Congratulations, Class of 2020 seniors.
Fellow Bishkop graduates, the tassel before graduation symbolizes your time as high school students. When you move it to the other side, you are confirming your new status as graduates. 2020 Bishkop graduates, you may now move your tassel from the right to the left, signifying your new status as Bishkop High School alumni.